Welcome to the course on Test Your C Programming Skills, A Guide to Crack IT Interview. We are discussing third topic of this course, that is arrays and pointers. In this session, we are going to discuss relationship between pointers and constants, void pointer, null pointer, and dangling pointer. Let's get started with some key points about pointers and constant. See the declaration given, const int star ptr or int const star ptr. This is a declaration for pointer to constant integer. In this case, value pointed by pointer can't be changed. However, pointer can be made to point to some other variable. See the second declaration, that is int star const ptr. This is a declaration of a constant pointer. In this case, value pointed by pointer can be changed. However, pointer can't be made to point to some other variable. A void pointer can point to any data type. Void pointer cannot be directly dereferenced. There is a need to cast the address to other pointer data type before dereferencing a void pointer. Also, pointer arithmetic is not allowed on void pointer. There are certain advantages of using void pointer. The library functions like malloc and calloc return a void pointer. Hence, these functions can be used to allocate memory for any type of data. Also, void pointer is useful to implement generic functions in C language. Let's get started with first example of this session. See the code carefully given on the screen, and you need to identify which statement, that is 1, 2, or 3, or 4, will give compiler error. And if we remove that statement, then what will be the output? In the program, there are two integer variables declared, that is a p and q. On line number 7, there is a pointer declaration. PTR pointer is pointing to variable p on line number 8, that is statement 1. PTR variable is pointing to variable q, and that is statement 2, which is there on line number 10. Then we are trying to change the value pointed by PTR to 30 on line number 12, and that is statement 3. And on line number 14, there is a statement which is changing the value of a variable p, which is statement 4. And the correct answer of this question is, in this program, statement 3 raises a compiler error. If we comment out statement 3, then output is 10, 20, 20, and 11. Let's understand why we are getting this output. On line number 7, a pointer variable is declared. That is int const pointer ptr. Here the pointer points to a constant integer. So in this case, value pointed by pointer can't be changed. Hence, statement 3 generates a compiler error. Here it is legitimate to make a pointer to point to another data, and that's why statement 1, 2, and 4, they are syntactically correct. And if we comment out statement 3, then we get the output as 10, 20, 20, and 11. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. There are 4 statements in the program. You need to identify which statement out of these 4 will give a compiler error. And if we remove that statement, then what will be the output? This program is similar to the previous one, with a difference on line number 7, wherein the pointer is declared like int star const ptr, which is pointing to variable p. So what is the answer of this question? In this case, statement 2 raises a compiler error, and if we comment out statement 2, then output is 10, 10, 30, and 31. Let's understand why we are getting this type of output. On line number 7, a pointer is declared using syntax int star const ptr. Here it declares a constant pointer to an integer. So it is not permitted to make this pointer to point another data. Hence, statement 2 generates the compiler error. However, value pointed by pointer can be changed. Hence, statement 1, 3, and 4 are accepted by the compiler. So if we comment out statement 2, then output is 10, 10, 30, and 31. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output of this code. There is a pointer declared on line number 5, and on line number 6 there is a printf statement. So what will be the output of this code? And the correct answer is, this program gives a compiler error at line number 6. Let's understand why we are getting a compiler error in this program. In the program on line number 5, there is a pointer declaration, that is int const pointer ptr. The pointer is pointing to constant integer, and on line number 6, there is an attempt to modify the value which is pointed by the pointer, and hence it generates the compiler error. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. On line number 5, there is a void pointer vptr. There are two variables, p and f. P is an integer variable, f is a float variable. On line number 8, vptr is pointing to variable p, and on line number 10, vptr is pointing to variable f. There are printf statements on line number 9 and 11. So what will be the output of this program? And the correct answer is, this program gives the output as a 10 and 11.2. Let's understand why we are getting this output. On line number 9, there is an attempt to display the value which is pointed by a void pointer. And on line number 8, void pointer is pointing to integer data. So for displaying the value correctly, it is necessary to typecast the void pointer using int star, and afterwards dereference operator is applied, and then we will get the correct output. In this program, vptr is a void pointer. A void pointer can hold the address of any type and can be typecasted to any data type. On line number 8, vptr stores the address of integer variable p. On line number 9, after typecasting, it displays the value of p. On line number 10, vptr stores the address of float variable f, and on line number 11, after typecasting, it displays the value of variable f. And that's why the output of this program is 10 and 11.2. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. In the program, there is a constant integer p, and there is an integer pointer ptr which is pointing to variable p. Then on line number 8, we are writing the statement like star ptr is equal to 20, and the value of p is displayed on the line number 9. So what will be the output of this program? And the correct answer is, this program gives the output 20. Let's understand why we are getting 20 as output of this program. In the program, p is a constant integer variable. Hence, any statement like p is equal to new value will generate a compiler error. However, instruction given on the line number 8 is accepted by the compiler. On line number 8, we are saying star ptr is equal to 20. So indirectly, we are trying to change the value of variable p, which is a constant variable. And that is acceptable. So pointers are useful to change the value of constant variable. However, if you would like to avoid this type of behavior, then you have to use pointer to constant. And that's why this program gives the output as a 20, and there is no compiler error in the program. Some key points about the null pointers. A null pointer is a pointer which is not pointing to any variable. Null pointers are useful to indicate that the pointer is not storing a valid address. For example, int star ptr. We can make ptr as a null pointer by saying ptr is equal to 0, or we can also write ptr is equal to capital null to indicate that it is a null pointer. A dangling pointer is a pointer pointing to a memory location that has been deleted or freed. The causes behind dangling pointer is variable goes out of scope or memory for that variable is deallocated. So coming next is we'll discuss about double pointer, triple pointer, pointers to function and pointer as a return type. Till then, enjoy C programming.